Hey everyone. In this video, we're going to be coding the middle Riemann sum in Python. Let's briefly recall what Riemann sums are. Riemann sums are a numerical method that allows us to approximate a definite integral. These are the simplest forms of numerical integration and are commonly taught in early calculus courses. The middle Riemann sum will use the midpoint of our rectangle to approximate the area under the curve, hence the name. The schematic here should make this more clear. I'm going to be coding this in PyCharm, which is a free, downloadable, integrated design environment. Let's create a new file. Then we need to import our relevant Python libraries. As we are going to both be approximating the definite integral and graphing our function, we need two Python libraries. We need NumPy and Matplotlib. Let's come to our interpreter in the bottom right here. As you can see, it says MRS, as that is what we created earlier. Let's click this and hit Interpreter Settings. This is very important, as if you have the wrong interpreter selected, Python won't recognize the packages we are about to download. You can change your interpreter up at the top here. Once you have your right interpreter selected, let's click this small plus sign down here. We will then search for NumPy, select it, and install package. Then, we will repeat the same thing for Matplotlib. Now that all of our relevant Python packages are installed, let's close this window. We now need to import them. Let's type in import NumPy as np, and import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Next, we need to create two function definitions, one for our function that we are going to be approximating the integral for, and another optional function for its second derivative if you wish to find the maximum error, which we'll talk about later. Both these functions will take in some x value and return the result of the function. Let's now list some of our function parameters. We're going to initiate an iteration variable for later. Then we have our lower integration bound a, our upper integration bound b, and our number of equally spaced subintervals, n. Then, let's make this formula to find our step size, dx. Then, let's start our x variable at our lower integration bound a, plus half of our step size, dx. This is because our first value will be found at a plus half our step size. Then lastly, we'll initiate a variable called area sum to keep track of all of our rectangle areas every time we count a new one. In order to plot our function using Matplotlib, we need to create values for it. To do this, I'm going to make a variable called xtemp, which uses NumPy's linspace method. This creates a simple 1D matrix of n plus 1 sections from A to B. We need to use n plus 1 here, as our number of inputs required is always going to be 1 more than our number of subsections. Let's then add half of our step size to all these values to shift our evaluation point to the middle of the rectangles as opposed to the left side. Now, we have one value at the end of xtemp that is b plus half our step size, and we don't want that there. So, to resolve this, I'm just going to select all values in our xtemp variable and move them into our x variable, except the last value, and this will resolve our issue. Then, to find the outputs at all of these equally spaced intervals, all we need to do is call our earlier function with the 1D matrix as our input variable. We are now going to solve for the middle Riemann sum, and I'm going to do that in two ways. Firstly, we are going to use a while loop. We can say that while I is strictly less than our number of subintervals, our area is our step size times the function evaluated at the middle of the rectangle. We then add this value to our area sum term, increase our x positioning, and our iteration counter, and then we let the loop continue. Secondly, you could use NumPy's sum method to just take our 1D Y matrix from earlier and times it by our step size. Both these methods shown will give the same result. Let's just go ahead and print the results of both these methods to validate that they are indeed the same. And there we go. Next, let's add in a way of calculating the maximum error of our middle Riemann sum. This section will be finding the maximum second derivative of our function that will then be plugged into the following formula. Our 1D matrix of x2 prime here is just saying that within the bounds a to b, create an arbitrary amount of inputs. I just put n times 100. The more points created here, the more accurate your answer will be, with the trade-off of slightly longer program runtimes. Printing the maximum error, you can see that with more subintervals, our maximum possible error decreases as we would expect. At this point, we are essentially done with finding our middle Riemann sum. I'm just going to add a small fprint statement that returns our value and the maximum possible error that we found. Lastly, I'm just going to add a couple lines of matplotlib code to print out a bar graph with markers to demonstrate our middle Riemann sum. As you can see, increasing our number of subintervals allows us to better approach our analytical solution of 305.3. Additionally, if you want to add more of the function to your matplotlib bar graph, we can just add this small bit of code that will simply evaluate our function outside of our boundaries a and b. Recall that this final parameter is simply our number of inputs, evaluated so too few, and our graph will look non-smooth. Lastly, this later line, we'll just add our function to our output. Changing our input bounds, we will get to see more of the underlying function. And there we go, we have now just coded a very simple middle Riemann sum code that can find the middle Riemann sum, the middle Riemann sum maximum error, and provide you with a simple graph. I will say that this is not the most intricate or concise Riemann sum code. I wanted to ensure that it was simple and easy to read above all else. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to code the middle Riemann sum in Python. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.